Examiner Resource Application Overview. The Examiner Resource Application, or ERA, is a work management and payment system used to track court-appointed examiner assignments and pay examiner invoices. ERA provides exam and case-related information, gives you the ability to view and manage work assignment details and deadlines, and to upload documents to qualify for roster. It allows you to conveniently manage expenses and submit invoices for payment in one system, and it provides the status of invoices. In this video, we'll show you how to complete these tasks and give you an overview of the application. To access ERA, go to era.courts.state.mn.us. If you've been directed to use this secured site and do not have a user account, click My Court MN to create and verify a user account. Remember, information on this site is considered secure and confidential. Do not give out your sign-in or password information. If you already have an account, click Login, select Examiner/Institution, and enter your login information. This is the dashboard. It's the page you see when you log in, and it's where you go to manage your profile, assignments, expenses, and invoices. Work requests you are assigned today will appear here. Click the Work Request ID number to view full details of the assignment. To view all active work requests, click here. If you have questions regarding an assignment, such as requesting extra travel time or pre-approved expenses, click Send Comments and enter your questions. An email and notification will be sent to the ERA coordinator to review your submission. The coordinator will review the information and contact you as needed. For urgent matters, call the coordinator directly. When a confidential work request is created in ERA and a coordinator selects an examiner to perform the work request will appear in the examiner's dashboard as a tentative work request. Click here to review the assignment and ensure there is not a conflict of interest. Contact your ERA coordinator with any questions or concerns. Click here to view closed work requests. Closed work requests are those that the examiner has completed and marked as closed, or those that have been closed because the case was dismissed, the examiner was dismissed, or there was a conflict of interest. Any past due work requests will appear here and be flagged on the Active Work Requests page. Past due work requests are those that have had no expenses entered after 65 days of being assigned to the work request. If no work has occurred on this work request and no expenses should be entered, then the examiner can close the work request expenses. If after 90 days the work request has not had any expenses entered and the work request has not been closed, the examiner will be flagged as inactive and will no longer be able to receive new work requests. Use these quick link icons to quickly access your profile, work requests, invoices, and a list of ERA coordinators. The Examiner Profile page allows you to view and edit your account information. You can also access your profile from the Account drop-down. Select the Profile tab to view and edit contact information and to view profession information including roster status, education, and vendor code. Click here to opt in or out of email notifications. You will still receive notifications via the notification icon at the top of the page. Select the Exam Types and Rates tab to view and edit what types of exams you are qualified and willing to evaluate, to view rates for those exam types, and to indicate to which districts you are willing to travel. Make sure you check the counties within each district you are willing to travel to and the specific exams you will conduct. These are not checked by default. You'll need to do this for each county within a district. Click Manage County and Exam Type and select a district. You may select all exams within a county or check and uncheck individual exams. Click Save to save your settings. Only those districts with counties you've checked will appear here. To request a rate exception, click Request for New Exception Group and enter the reason for the request. Your request will be submitted and reviewed by the Psych Services Program Administrator. Select the Qualifications tab to view qualifications and upload documentation to qualify for the roster. To upload a file, click the arrow, select the file, and click Upload Document. Note that examiner reports will continue to be filed through EFS. If you have an affiliation with an institution, select the Institutions tab to view that information. Open My Work Requests to view court appointments that have been assigned to work requests. You may view requests that are active, tentative, or closed. On the Active tab, click the ID number to open and view the details of a work request and MNSIS case event details. The Close a Work Request button will appear within your work request profile. Use this function to indicate you've been dismissed from the case has been dismissed, or if there is a conflict of interest. You'll also use this as a way to indicate you have completed the appointment and invoiced all of your expenses. Once you have invoiced your expenses, the Close Work Request button will not be active until the expenses are in a submitted for payment status. Make sure to enter additional information in the comments for audit purposes. Click Billing to add service or travel expenses for a specific work request. To add a new service expense, click Add New Service Item, enter date of service, service type, and the number of service hours and minutes. The subtotal is auto-calculated. Add any supporting comments and choose Save as Unbilled. This allows you to save expenses in an unbilled status within your work requests if you are not ready to submit an invoice at this time. Or you can select Save to Billing Queue if you will be preparing to submit an invoice momentarily. To add a new travel expense, click Add New Travel Item, enter the travel date, and the start and end location. The mileage is auto-calculated and the travel expense subtotal appears. Enter the requested time in the Requested Minutes field. If your trip was delayed by weather, construction, or other unforeseen circumstance, enter a reason for the request, and Save as Unbilled or Save to Billing Queue. Click the Comments tab to submit new comments or view previous comments that have been entered into the work request. Click My Invoices to generate an invoice and manage other invoicing-related tasks. Select Billing Queue to view and manage billed expenses and generate an invoice. Select My Pending to review and update an invoice that has been returned. Select Under Review to view where an invoice is in the approval process. Select Approved to view details of invoices that have been submitted for payment. The PDF version of the invoice can be found here. To generate an invoice, click the Billing Queue tab. Select the expenses you want to submit and click Generate Invoice. Be sure to review the preview of the invoice for accuracy. Click Submit to send the invoice for approval. If you need to make additional edits, click Cancel. Expenses that have not been sent to the billing queue will not be submitted for payment. Go to the Billing tab within the work request, select the unbilled expenses, and click Send Checked to Billing Queue. Select ERA Coordinators List to view a list of district coordinators and their contact information. Be sure to contact the appropriate coordinator for the invoice you are inquiring about. Find a quick view of all new and unread notifications here. Click View All to open and view all notifications, such as new assignments, tentative confidential assignments, documents received, roster status changes, and important invoicing notifications. Click the drop-down to submit a request for technical support assistance. Settings is where you'll go to view your login history and edit your MyCourt MN account information, in addition to changing your security questions, password, and email. Click here to log out. Make sure to log out of your account when not in use. You are responsible for your account's security. To help guide your daily tasks, such as entering expenses and invoicing, check out the resources on the mncourt.gov Psychological Psychiatric Examiner Service Program site.